LXML is a fast and feature-rich library used to handle XML and HTML in Python, but you can also use it for web data extraction. And that's exactly what we're going to take a look at today. I'm Lisa, and in this video, you'll learn how to create XML documents, process them, and use the LXML library for scraping. Let's get to it. Before you start coding, let's take a look at the structure of a simple XML document. You can visualize any XML or XML-compliant HTML as a tree. This means it will have a root and branches. Each branch may split into further branches. Also, the root and all of its branches are represented as an element. An HTML that is compliant with XML will follow the same concept, but you should note that HTML may or may not be compliant. For instance, if an HTML document contains BR without a matching closing tag, it is still valid HTML, but it will not be valid XML. Now that we cleared that up, let's start working with the LXML library. You can download and install it using the pip package manager. This works on Windows, Mac, and Linux. For Windows, you can also just use pip install LXML, assuming you're running Python 3. To create an XML document, start by importing the E3 module. As mentioned, every XML document begins with a root. Use the element type to create it. The element type is a flexible container object able to store hierarchical data. You can imagine it as a cross between a dictionary and a list. Since you need to create an HTML that is XML compliant, the root element will have its name as HTML. Also, every HTML will have a head and a body. To create parent-child relationships, you can use the sub-element type. Its constructor takes two arguments, the parent node and the element name. Use the following code to print and see how everything works so far. To make the output more readable, set pretty_print to true. If your HTML prints fine, move on to adding more sub-elements like title and headings. One good thing about LXML is that it's easy to set text. With every instance on the element and sub-element, you have two methods, text and set. The former is used to specify the text and the latter to set the attributes. One thing to note is that the attribute can also be passed in the constructor of sub-element. Afterwards, add some paragraphs. Now you can save it in a Python file and run it. It will print an HTML, which is also a well-formed XML. You can see that E3 dump is used here. It actually writes everything to the console without returning anything. It's good for debugging, but shouldn't be used for other purposes. On the other hand, toString is used for serialization. It will return a string you can store in a variable or write to a file. So, if you add the following lines, it will save the contents to input HTML and in the same folder you were running the script. Now, let's move on to transversing and manipulating an existing XML document. First, save the following snippet as input HTML. You'll also find a link to the snippet in the video description. When you parse an XML document, the result is an in-memory element tree object. The raw XML contents can be in a file system or a string. It can be loaded using the parse method if in a file system. The parse method will return an object of type element tree. Call the getRoot method to get the root element. Also, the LXML E3 module exposes another method that can be used to parse contents from a valid XML string. It's called fromString. This method returns an object of element. There is no need to call getRoot. To find elements using LXML, you can employ two different approaches. The first is to use the Python LXML querying languages XPath and ElementPath. For example, this code will return the first paragraph element. Note that the selector is very similar to XPath. Also, you don't need to use the root element name because LM contains the root of the XML tree. If you use findAll, you'll get a list of all the elements matching the selector. The second way is by using XPath directly. This is easier for developers who are familiar with XPath. Also, it can be used to return the instance of the element, the text, or the value of any attribute using standard XPath syntax. So far, you've been working with a well-formed XML-compliant HTML. But this won't always be the case. In these situations, you can simply use lxml.html instead of lxml.h3. Note that reading straight from a file is not supported. File contents should be read in a string first. This code prints all the paragraphs from the same HTML file. Now you know how to find and parse elements in XML and HTML, but you also need to learn about getting the HTML of a web page. You can use the request library for this. Simply install it using the pip package manager. You can then retrieve the HTML of any web page using a simple get method. As you can see, the source HTML is printed. Combine this with LXML to retrieve the necessary data. For example, this code will print a list of countries from Wikipedia. Here, the HTML returned is parsed into the variable tree. This can be queried using standard XPath syntax. The XPath can be concatenated. Note that the XPath method returns a list. This means only the first item is taken in this code snippet. You can easily extend it to read any attribute from the HTML. For example, the following modified code prints the country name and image URL of the flag. And that's it. If you like this video, leave a comment below and subscribe to our channel. And for more scraping-related questions, drop us a line via email. Thanks for joining and see you soon!